What's going on, everybody? Patriot Stacker here. I got a whole bunch of silver to show you. Stay tuned. What's going on, everyone? So I have a whole bunch of new silver pieces that I can't wait to show you. So not everything you see on the screen is brand new, just a few things here. So first off, I made an order with JM Bullion, and it's been a while since I ordered anything from the online silver bullion dealers, and I decided I wanted to get a couple pieces, and I saw some interesting things that they had. So these are not silver, they are silver plated nickel. But I thought they were cool. They were only a couple bucks. Well, they're about $15 a piece. But they are the 100th anniversary centennial Peace Dollar and Morgan Dollar. So they come with a little certificate of authenticity. And they come in a capsule with a cool little stand. And I got two of each. So I'll show you what they look like here. So they're on like this little stand. And they're proof-like. And it says 1921 through 2021. Really cool. It's got that high relief look to the Peace Dollar. Really beautiful. It says Centennial down at the bottom, Peace. So it looks just like a Peace Dollar with a couple added features. Just a really gorgeous piece. And they're silver plated nickel. So I got the Peace Dollar as well as the Morgan Dollar. 1921 through 2021, 100th year anniversary. Really cool piece. So I picked up two of those and I thought they were kind of cool. You know, I'll keep them on my desk for, you know, on display. So that was kind of an interesting thing. They're not, you know, completely silver, but they are definitely a cool piece. But I did get four silver bullion coins and rounds. So the first one here, to kind of go along with that, the Peace and Morgan dollars are this really cool coin here. It is the 100th anniversary of the Peace and Morgan dollar silver coin. Has a $1 face value. Really interesting. And this is from the British Virgin Islands. So 2021, it's got the Queen, British Virgin Islands. It's a gorgeous coin, polished fields, a little frostiness in the background as well. Looks really cool. So I thought that was a cool little piece to go with my tribute rounds here. And then as soon as I get my actual 2021 Morgan and Peace dollars, this will be a cool little set to keep all together. I also got this. This is a coin as well. One troy ounce, 3/9 fine silver. This is the Napoleon Angel series, I believe. Just a really cool design. I like that a lot. These are from St. Helena, 2021, East India Company. So pretty cool. It's got a 1 pound face value. And it's one troy ounce of 3/9 fine. It's got some cool security features in the background. I just thought the design was really interesting. It's definitely a beautiful coin. So I picked that one up as well. And then I really think these are so cool. These are one troy ounce, 3/9 fine. And these are from Nui. These are the Nui Owls. It has a $2 face value. And I actually have the ones from 2020, so I figured I'd pick some up from the 2021 series. They're a little bit shinier, a little bit different of a design, a little bit more polished. And the nice frosty owl on there. Really cool. Kind of pays tribute to the old Greece drachma coins. Really, really awesome. So I picked up two of those. They're both the same, both 2021s. I just love that design. So those are from JM Bullion. These 4 ounces and then the four Peace and Morgan tribute rounds. So I was happy with my purchase from JM Bullion. I also made a purchase from Etsy. There's a coin dealer on Etsy that I buy a lot of foreign silver coins from. Actually, all different types of foreign coins and U.S. coins as well. But he's got really cool stuff, and he, you know, has pretty good prices. So I've been buying stuff from him lately. I picked up 3 new half dollars. So they're not are any typical half dollar. These are Balboas. This is a Medio Balboa, which is half, and they correspond to our United States Constitutional Silver. So they're 90%, and this is the exact same silver content as like a Walking Liberty half dollar, and it's from 1930, and all the dates correspond too. So, you know, from the early 1900s through 1964, the Panamanian Balboas are 90% silver. Really cool. I love the design. Such a awesome piece. It's got some great toning going on. So that's 90% silver. And then just like our U.S. Constitutional, you see this is another Medio Balboa, but this is from 1968. So just like a 1968 Kennedy half dollar, these are 40% silver. And this is a Brilliant Uncirculated. Gorgeous piece here. Same design, just a little later date, a little less pure silver content, so it's only 40%. So really cool. I picked those up for not a bad deal at all. And then this one is one of the first of that I have in my stack. This is a 1954 from Portugal. I love the design with the ship. Looks so cool. República Portugal. Or Portuguesa, so from the Republic of Portugal. This is a 10 escudos, really cool design, and I just think they're awesome. These are 83% silver, I believe. Honestly, I can't remember right now, but I think they're somewhere in the 80 or 83%, but they're the exact same diameter as any of the Balboas or US half dollars. So I'm putting that in my half dollar collection because I have this tube here. I only needed 3 more to fill the tube. So I have a couple of these Balboas that I had previously. A 90% silver from 1930, a 90% silver. The design's a little slightly a little different in 1953. This one's got some funky toning, kind of cool. And then I also have this awesome toned, if I can get that to show up, really beautiful colors in this one. And this is a 40% silver from 1966. And this thing has amazing rainbow toning. So I filled my tube of half dollars. I have all different commemoratives and seated liberties and all random cool half dollars in that tube. And I filled it up. So I was really excited about that. And if you saw my video yesterday, I mentioned I went to my LCS and I picked up one coin. And they didn't really have a whole lot in stock. I was looking for something. I wanted to pick up some foreign coins, a couple pounds of random foreign coins. They didn't have them sorted yet. So they did have this, and I picked this up for a pretty nice deal as well. This is a one Balboa. So this has the exact same silver content as a Morgan or Peace dollar. And you'll see here it says lei 0.900, so 90% silver and 26.73 grams. So really, really cool. And this is a Balboa from Panama, 1934. And I love this design. This is their earlier design. And it has the Lady Liberty holding the fasces and the oak and laurel, and it's just such an awesome design. I just think it is beautiful, and it's got great history. So I picked that up. That was I think I paid $30 for that. So I also have a handful of other Un Balboas, so that'll go in the stack with those. Here's a little bit better condition, 1947 with that older design. And then you'll see here, later on, they went back to this design in 1966. That is 90% silver. And then we have this beautifully toned. It's hard to even see that, but it has an awesome rainbow halo effect going on. That's 1971, but this was a proof, silver proof. So that is 90% silver as well. So we got a whole bunch of really cool stuff. I also purchased this off of eBay because it was really inexpensive and I thought it was very interesting. It is a sterling silver collectible spoon. So I don't know if I can get it to show up here. It's got some really cool filigree design. It says sterling right there. It's hard to see, but this is from, see if I can get this to show up, the 1894 California Midwinter Exposition. And if you you might not know or have never heard of the California Midwinter Exposition, it was held in San Francisco in 1894. It was a huge expo, just like the it was a few years later what they would have the San Francisco Exposition as well in 1914, I believe, which are these huge expos, these huge festivals that are very interesting if you dive into the history about those. So it has this beautifully, really beautiful ornate Greco-Roman style building. It's kind of hard to see on the spoon, but if you dive into the history about these expositions, they are extremely interesting. And there's actually quite a bit of, controversy, you might want to say, behind some of those expos. Some of the architecture that they built or that they had during these expositions are amazing. These Greek Roman style pillars and beautiful ornate architecture for the expositions and then to be torn down, which is crazy. So dive into that if you're interested in some cool history. So I picked that up, sterling silver. It was only a few bucks. I thought that was really interesting, and it was from the 19th century. We got a whole bunch of silver. I'm really excited. We got some cool pieces. I might throw some of these up on auction sometime soon. But that is my pickup from LCS, from JM Bullion, from Etsy, and from eBay, all over the place. Thank you so much for watching today. Smash that like button if you enjoyed what you saw. Subscribe to the channel if you like videos just like this, all about silver stacking, coin collecting, precious metals, all that fun stuff. And ring that notification bell so you can see when I upload my next video. And as always, have a great day.